This show's 12 hours at the famous Bay of Fundy in Nova Scotia, Canada. Day it's the biggest day, tide change in the world.
Alone on a hill,
but what force could move such a massive
man
body of
water?
Man
with a foolish grin is keeping perfectly still.
Gravity.
But nobody wants to know him. I can see that he's just a fool.
Could be added as further proof of the existence of a cosmic breath that the high temperatures of July and August, which are really abnormal, since it should be cooler as they occur, when the days become shorter and the height of the sun decreases, that they are due, in fact, as in the function of respiration, the pressure of the breathing out is greater towards the middle of the expiration phase, and consequently, the temperature rises. On the other hand, it is observed that the cold becomes more intense in January and February. Although the days are growing longer and the decrease in the intensity of the cold breath is causing the sun to rise. This recrudescence of the cold is due to the same reason of pressure increase in the middle of the phase of expiration. And the cosmic breath being cold, it follows that there is a further drop of temperature during this period, from which it can be seen that the pressure of the respective cosmic breath streams is susceptible of warming or cooling in the atmosphere, as the case may be. Regardless of the height of the sun. It may be remarked that during the time of the solstices, when the height of the sun at midday is stabilized for a few days, either at its highest or lowest point in the heavens, man, by reflex, follows the cosmic conditions by stopping his working activities and taking a rest in fall. These particular moments are also the occasion of great religious Christic festivals, Christmas at the winter solstice, and Corpus Christi at the time of the summer solstice, which points undoubtedly to the existence of an association between the sun and Christ. This association exists also in the case of the Easter festival of the resurrection of Christ, which in reality celebrates the solar new year. Easter takes place on the Sunday following the new moon, after the spring equinox on March 21, which date marks the beginning of the spring and summer cycle of the sun. When the height of the latter at noon begins to rise over the equator, according to the actual astronomical way of reckoning the solar declination. It is also obvious that the opposition of the seasons north and south of the equator results from a corresponding opposition in the circulation of the two breaths around the Earth, i.e. when the warm breath is in the northern hemisphere, the cold one is in the other, and vice versa, so that it is simultaneously summer in one part of the world and winter in the other. Thus, the warm six-month breath, which commenced in the northern hemisphere at the spring equinox, comes to an end at the autumn equinox, about the 22nd of September, when the transposition of the warm and cold breath takes place. The warm breath passes in the southern hemisphere for the spring-summer cycle, and at the same time the cold breath leaving said hemisphere enters ours for the autumn-winter cycle. The respective intensities of the two breaths